Welcome to the show, one and all. This is Dan Wiggly Doggy coming to you with another episode of This Land Is My Land. And today, we are going to continue our campaign. We're on day 116, 16 camps, 415 warriors, and 46% of our land back. Now, the 46% of my land back has given me pause. And I need to start thinking about mid-game action. So, I want to start making sure that everybody is ready to go. Everybody has the right arms in each village. Make sure each of my villages are well occupied. Make sure I have my villages in the right spots. All that kind of good stuff. I imagine today, after the next clearing of area, which is going to be towards the middle of the map, that will peak the 50%, and somewhere between 40 and 60% should trigger some mid-game actions to come. Don't want to really do a spoiler alert if you've never played this game, so you'll see what I'm talking about at that point. I've got different tactics for the action that should be coming at some point here. So we're going to do a little village micromanaging. It shouldn't be too bad. I think I only have like 5 or 6 villages since the last time I cleared them all out. So this should go fairly quick. Then we'll get on into some action. And as I recall, I wanted to bring these war party guys over to this neutral village. And then I'll dump the war party guys into that village. So let's take a look at the map. First off, most of my, most of my villages are fully occupied. Got a couple that aren't in the right order. Number one, that's not a big deal. And they have 28. So they're full after. So, in theory, I could easily add another village if I so choose. And what I like are clusters of 3. I like 3 villages here. Ideally, I would have 1 village on a major intersection, such as this. If you notice on the roads, even though they'll veer off, when it comes down to being towards the center, there's pretty much, you know, 2 roads here. One comes from this side, one comes from that side, and then it veers off again. If you get to these intersections, and you can block 1, 2. Let's see, ideally you would have 1, 2. This one's kind of tricky. 3, 4, 5. See, basically where all the roads converge and then they narrow down to 1 road to go towards the center. If you put a village somewhere around there, a blocker village, and then have a core in the center of defending the villages that can help defend those blocker villages, then you're going to be golden as far as maintaining control and having a good outcome if you get attacked. But having 3 villages close together isn't a bad thing either. Any one of these villages gets attacked, then you can have the other 2 help. So that's kind of my my basic goal as I build, is I want to have 2 villages to be able to help any village that gets attacked. Now, as you can see, I can probably reach here, barely, but only 1 village can help this guy out. So this guy is isolated a lot more than I want, But, on the other hand, this guy is nowhere near the road. So unless they're directly coming for this village, they should leave that village alone. So I'm kind of... I don't know if I want to establish another village there or not. It's really not going to have much use besides helping out with this one. Kind of like this. This village really isn't going to have much use, but these three villages can defend each other. And you come down here and these two can defend each other. These three actually can defend each other. Same here. These guys are all safe, able to help each other out. So I only have one village that's isolated. Do I care? That's the question. Now see, I only have one village here, so I wouldn't want to put a village right here in this major intersection, which is more than likely going to see action. Because I don't have enough villages to defend effectively. I mean, I would still win any fight, but I would probably lose a lot more warriors than I would be okay with. So, down in this region, or here, or here ideally, I suppose not. Ideally, actually. Alright, well, let's see if we can just do that. Do I have rope? We'll send... I don't know why two, but whatever. We do not have rope. Okay. I like it. Get that. There. That's a cherry spot right there, too. Yeah, I think I like that spot. I don't need two beds, I just need one. Alright, so we're gonna do that. There's really not much else I need to adjust. I've gotten better at not having to, not having to change too many placements. That gets really expensive with the upgrades. Control. Okay, so what I want to do, I want to take any weapon I don't want my warriors using in the fight out. I don't really care about all that. I don't really have to take all this stuff out, but I'm going to. I'm going to leave any treatments that are in the villages there. But I don't want them using handguns, and I don't want them using low-quality guns. And I don't mind losing war bows. You don't need those. Don't care about the perks. I want to make sure I get these transferred out of this campaign when I'm done. Unless it becomes a good leader. Then it will live forever. I think the hardest thing to come by in this game is a solid leader. That's one of the most valuable assets you could have, too. But it's, you know, I mean, you could set up leader campaigns that'll do what you need to do, but an effective leader campaign is actually pretty difficult to achieve. Very time consuming. Now your only limit on weight carrying capacity beyond the fact that you won't be able to move if you carry too much are guns. But number wise, the only thing that you're limited on picking up at one time are guns. So you can only pick up, I want to say it's 149 total guns or bows. But you can pick up millions of pelts, millions of pretty much anything else. And that affects what you can transfer through the mail system. You can only put, you get 21 letters in the mail. So if I want to move items from this campaign to a new campaign, I would open mail. This guy. And you get 21 mail. See how I have 1,000 grocery in each one of these? I can bring those in. But if I want to move all my items over to a new campaign, I can pretty much put everything that's not a gun or a bow in one letter. So I can gather it all, put it on me, and then put it into one letter. And then each set of each letter after that, I would put 149 guns or bows. So it's not as difficult as you might think to transfer a campaign from one to the next. Okay. Let's get all this in. There's been a little bit of drama with people using exploits in the chat lately. It's kind of sad and funny at the same time. But drama is very short-lived with this community. We don't need it. It won't last very long. Do this real quick. You don't need any of that. And I don't necessarily have to do this. I just kind of choose to. Because I like having my stuff all in one spot. What am I doing? It's easier to tell what you have and you always know what it is. Why am I? I wonder if they adjusted the weight carrying capacity with the new update. I've only been back for a month, but I should have been able to pick everything up. I didn't have very many guns on me. Did I? Maybe I'm just tripping. Let's see, did I finish file? No, I did not. Alright, well, let's, find out if there's a limit on the items you can put on yourself now. Curious. So I'm gonna pick up everything except for guns. 7, 1, 8. Let's see if I can just keep adding to my inventory. Actually, I know a better system. I just want to get this done. I'll try something in a minute. It'll be a lot quicker. I didn't want to take the meat. I like to leave some meat in every village. That way, if they do become overpopulated, I'm not going to lose warriors. So I'll just leave that. So we're on 10, 11. might pause the game while I do this, just so I don't get it interrupted. Have some patrol go hit a village while I'm not paying attention. And like I said, I don't think this will take too long. Starting to see a few regular quality guns. Nice, still going on. People are funny. Just people are definitely funny. I do like my gun parts. I've got quite the gun part collection. I would guess that I've gathered at least 70% of all the loot I've ever come across. So yeah, I'm a loot hound for sure. At least 70%. I never leave loot behind. You never know what's going to be added to the game and when you're going to wish you had a couple thousand particular gun parts or something. You never know. I wonder if we're going to be able to build trains. The devs were saying something about adding trains, interactive trains, with the next major update. Imagine if you could buy a train. I could buy a train. That would be awesome. If you could lay track, that'd be wicked. Like, why would you lay tracks in between villages though? That wouldn't make much sense, would it? In the in-train line? I'm imagining we're just going to be able to blow it off the track and raid it. Kind of like the wagons. That, or they'll probably use the trains to invade your land. So as they push out, they'll lay tracks, and if you push back, they'll send reinforcements quicker. You think the patrols are difficult to deal with? Oh yeah, wait till they're on a train. That's actually pretty cool. I haven't really thought about what. They're going to be supply and troop movers. You're going to have to blow them off the track using a charge. It'd be kind of cool to be able to jump on a train. That would take a lot of development, I would suspect. Jumping into a train and then taking them out as they're sitting in the chairs or laying in the beds or whatever. I say. Got me some gold. That's taking a second. And did I do 11? I forgot what number I was on. This might be kind of a pain in the butt to have to deal with, but it will pay off in the long run. Oh, these guys are busy. Look at all these guns. These guys have been doing some work. Damn. Is that 13? Coming up on a million items in this village. Of course, a lot of those I think are probably dimes. Huh? 21,000, that's not many at all. Where are... I need to bring these bad boys back. Six. Those are my just-in-case backups. I suppose I could, let these guys travel to the new village. While we do this. Oh, did it again. So these camps have been given a pretty good amount of to my villagers, I think. Okay. Is that 13, 14? So I really only need to, I think, take one, maybe two more global zones, regions, and then be above the 50 mark. And when I get about 55, 60, I'm going to kind of swallow my roll for a little while. I'll give them a chance to figure out what they want to do. And that is, in my opinion, a big part of the game with people is, so you wanna move quickly to get to a certain point, and then you wanna slow down to give them time to counteract. I mean, if you wanna get the most out of a campaign, you wanna see everything that a campaign has to offer. You know, there's certain ways that are beneficial to play. Make it more likely. It's not a guarantee that you're going to get play a certain way. But if you just go in and kill, and I've noticed that a lot lately with these guys that like to do kill campaigns, which nothing wrong with that. You just go in and kill everybody. But basically, I like to take my time with the campaign. I'm not in a big rush to complete it for the most part. Although I'm always anxious to see if I can trigger the things, the mid-game action and the late-game action. I'm always curious if what I'm trying to do is going to work. You never really know until you know, basically. I'm kind of wondering, since the update, I haven't completed a campaign since the update, I'm wondering if they've changed anything. Any of the triggers or any of the actions. I can't guarantee. Obviously things could be the way they were when I left the game a year ago, so. So far it's all familiar. And I'm also rethinking, so I've been running into a problem, or I don't know if you would even call it an issue. What was that? Get back on track. 14. So I run into this problem where I give the town plenty of time and space to expand. So this last town that I hit only had like 15, 20 dudes in it, even though the game kept saying it was increasing its population, it was sending out gatherers that made it back, it was doing all this shit, and it kept saying, oh, it's upgrading and getting bigger and bigger. But then when I go and attack it, it's still just a tiny castle town, in my opinion. I mean, it was super easy to just go in and wipe it out. So I've been wondering, because I never killed, and I've got to kind of investigate. I'm wondering if it might be beneficial to kill early on in order to entice them to actually expand and grow and get stronger, bring in better weapons, that kind of good stuff, and then slow your roll and go into stun and kill once they're established. So I've got to kind of, I'm going to have to play with that whenever I find the time to do it. Some experiment. Cause these little ass towns, 100 plus days in, are boring. I need to find some action. I need me a group of 60 guys, you know? You don't have too much of you. 16? Alright, we're on the last one. I don't want to take those yet. Alright, excellent. Excellent. That's all the loot from the camps. Drop all this off, then we gotta go upgrade. Put all would be such a nice add. I would not mind just putting everything in the square village at one time. I wanted to put this meat back in those villages too. Damn it, somebody knocked down one of my chat talking about. Stupid though. I'm not even gonna show you what this guy's crying about. Okay, let's give people a who has the that was a good response. Most people don't realize you can sell those dimes on the market and get social trading tokens. Which if you're kind of wondering if you're watching and you're wondering what I'm talking about, you go to social, you go to the trading window, you go to buying. Of course somebody just filled the order. Usually there's, oh there it is. So this is a computer generated offer. Any of these offers with the little slanted names are computer generated. So this one is, this and this are computer generated offers. See how it says 50,000 dimes? 100 dimes will be your main trading token. If you notice, where is it? I have 6,400, right? You notice I have dimes in my social. So I took dimes from the game. I hit put items, I put the dimes in there, I saved, and now they're uploaded into my social and I'm sitting with them here. I can sell these 50,000 dimes and make 4,000 trading tokens. Confirmed. Now this offer is going to go away, but it's a computer generated offer, so in an hour or two that offer will be back. It might be at a different price. It'll give you, you know, 6, 5, 8, or 9 per whatever it was, 100. But now I have 10,000 trading tokens. Really easy way to get trading tokens that nobody really uses. Now they're gonna go look and I just fall. Oops, sorry guys. Anyways, let's get back to what we're doing. What do I have on? Okay, the meat. Put 100 in. Oh well, I can do that on the screen. That's not what I wanted to do. Did I grab my phone? Social. Bread weighs so much. It's ridiculous. Ridiculous. Put all this in here. And am I close to this place? No. Good. So we're still on the plane. I don't think there's much happening right now. Thank you. Okay, that was easy enough. We're gonna go with, actually. So this is the new guy. I can send. I can send 14 safely to the new guy. You go there. You can go 5 to the new guy. And another thing that emptying your inventory in all the villages allows you to do is you can choose which weapon will get equipped. There's only one thing in there. They're only going to equip it with one thing, so that kind of speeds it up too. Because if I have stun arrows in here for some reason, this thing likes to give stun arrows. I don't get it. So if I hit equip, they're gonna give them stun arrows. Okay. So that was, what was that, 19? So we're at 20. And I wanna go with, we'll go for 5. 25 should be good. Oh. Alright. Now they have 25. And we want to come over here. What the hell's going on there? And so who would this be? I did the Indians, I did the dentist, I did the bandits, right? I don't know if I did the bandits. I think that was a different campaign. So this is probably bandits. Whatever it is, I need to get over to here. Looks like I can. And I still have one more. Need to select my bow. Alright, we're golden. What is that? Is that a patrol or? No, this has got to be. That's a brewery. Alcoholic drinks. I have not noticed this before. Huh. Interesting. Very interesting. Horses. It's a patrol. No, I don't want to put this in patrol. Now what you don't want to do is attack a patrol that's visiting a trader. But what I could do is cut them off. Here, it says that he's holding a melon, I can force him to eat that melon, so that he'll heal a little faster. Thank you. with their own following. I'm gonna go with stealth here.
I saw him! I saw the enemy! Hey! Over there!
Now,
enemy!
Get one of you guys off this.
I'm reloading. There's an enemy! Enemy spotted!
Get off.
I need to blow!
See anything?
They're here! They're here!
I'm reloading.
I need to reload!
Enemy spotted!
Enemy spotted!
Going with all the fire. You only eat one thing at a time, but it's the issue. Could be. Thought I heard more horses. I don't know who's dead, who's alive. What did I lose there? Two guys? That's seems like there's is there another patrol coming? That probably is a different control. One more. Yeah, patrol man. Got that waste of damage. Don't care about that. Don't care. Don't need that. I keep hearing horses. Right, I guess that's good. And there he is.
Who's that?
not right here. Enemy sighted!
Did I just shoot one of my own guys in the head? I think that's
right. There's an enemy!
Oh shit, they're all coming.
Enemy sighted! Guys, they're here!
Now why did you die?
Enemy sighted!
Okay, where? Well, don't shoot me up now. I just heal. Yeah, that one dude died. Bled out. And is that... guys? I didn't notice I had anybody injured. It looks like I got another patrol coming. See, I should have just gone to the damn camp. Stupid. So now I'm just gonna lose all these guys instead of dropping them off in the camp like I wanted to. I don't know why we call them camps either. It's a village. It's like a whole nother patrol of me. Seeing if I can detect anybody else. There's one dude there. Looks like that's probably it. No, there's another dude way back there. Thank you. That's all the stuff I dropped. Okay, I'm thinking this is probably the last guy in this patrol. He may well wake up before I can get to him. As he does. Looks like he's trying to get on his horse. Pounds every way. So if you go into social, I'm overweight, right? Oh, wait. I might as well. Shut up. This guy's still in charge. That's quite the death pose. Oh, the horse is whacking him. That's pretty funny. Your horse did not dig you at all. I want to see if there's any loot on this guy real fast. So grab all the loot. Go to social and go on the stick. What this is going to do is take me to the nearest camp or outpost. But I'll have my loot, my boys, and my horse. So it took out two patrols there. That should be some good skill points. Seemed like I killed a couple of them though. I'm not sure what that was. Now the unstuck is intended for when you get stuck on a rock. They used to charge you skill points to use that. Now they just charge you 60 seconds. So I'm like, alright, well, I'm not really using it the way it's intended, but it works for me. They'll probably end up changing that.
quicker than walking. Been reading the chat. Take a little peek at it in a second. Ah! Damn it! Seven of those don't hurt. I don't need seven. Let's get rid of some weight. Okay. I just want to up my stun rows a little bit. And what's chat talking about? Oh yeah. Okay, so let's try this again. Let's, it doesn't look like these patrols are gonna stop, so let's stop messing with them. That's just gonna be an endless supply of patrols there. Where am I going? I'm going down here. Actually, I wanted to take a peek. Still not on. Yeah. But I need to put some hay baits here. Because I used them the last time. There you go. Alright, we're going. We're good to go. Take a couple of horses. Now I've only got six guys to drop off. Where am I going? This stupid little indicator is not very good anymore. Can't go. I'm not going that way. And... Thank you.
from, what is it, 200? 200 stun arrows to knock a buffalo off? Like, for real. So you ever get super bored in your game, you want to practice horseback shooting. It's going to be hard to send warriors to this village, so it's good that I have all this crap around me to help me populate it. Who do you use? Five. Five. Eight can go to five. Okay. So we're going to send, like, four, I guess. Except five. Two. Alright. Don't have to worry about that now. Now, I always leave my upgrade items in the last village, unless they're in danger of being attacked. This is gonna bump us up a little bit on the amount of land that we have. It's gonna get us real close to 50. Now, there's actually another little trick I can show you. So, it's dangerous, and I'm only gonna do this once because I don't actually want to bring too many people here, but it's dangerous to like send warriors from here, any of these villages, down to this village, right? But if I go to a village that has excess of warriors, I can create a war party with just two. I don't even have to give them anything, right? So let's push play, and we're going to create those. Now, those two guys are with me, right? So now I can take them, I can disband them. This is another little cheesy thing. Hey, I can disband these boys, and guess where they're gonna go? Don't you do it! Don't you come over here, guys! Now all these warriors are going to go into this village, and that village is not quite so at risk. Okay, now the bigger question is, that's actually a really good spot for this village too. These two can defend, so I've got my little triangle of defense going. So what I want to do is I'm going to want to wipe this guy out. I get a feeling if I take out these patrols, they're just gonna respawn, so that's gonna be a waste of time. One more thing I wanna do is make sure I have enough warbows in this village. What do I want? Like, 250, just to be safe. And let's give them some meat. Just to be overly safe. Okay. There you go. We're solid. I'm not gonna care about groceries right now. They'll get plenty from the spawn. Alright, so let's say and then we'll go take out that camp and that farm. I don't need any more war parties hanging out with me. As best I can, get a little glimpse of what we got. Perfection. One more for good luck. I didn't bring anything to increase my stamina.
What's that?
Yeah, so we were all down by the river, and, well, something...
Everyone get ready! Here they are!
Spotted. Chabasta. Trying to stay in the bushes, because I have full camo and grass.
Hey!
Oh, I'm just like... teasing this guy.
I saw them! They're out there!
Come on, you still not knocked down? You wanker. Right in the shoulder. I'm not gonna use that arm tonight, son.
Something's not right here.
You think? It's alright for me. Is that the guy that was spotting me? No. Boom. Alright. That went fairly well. I'm doing this kind of backwards just because... See, I already lost this guy. I have no idea where this dude is. Alright, whatever. I'll come back to you. Let's get these other guys first. So a smart warrior goes back to where he started, picks them up first. That's kind of weird. It's like a muddy board. Oh, that's my graphics. Huh. I've been playing around with the settings, trying to get it to be able to smooth. I'm going to have to adjust. I've got to have a boatload of skill points by now. I don't have anything else I care about to upgrade though. Let's see if we can find that guy that's out of the bush. Yeah, you guys are all confused, aren't you? Just a tad too big. Okay, did I forgot a guy over there? Yeah, that should probably... Back on concentration.
ugliness going on. Texture quality terrain. Maybe I should go back to Ultra. Model quality is still. I wonder if it's the grass. I bet it's the grass. Alright, let's see how that goes. Why? Ooh, what? You suck. Damn it. Yeah, you always want to check your paths to make sure it's safe. That's not okay. Five guys is gonna have a hard time. Yeah. Yeah, I saw it. Bastards. I'm not even gonna take the time to send these guys with food and stuff, which I should. See how you like this, asshole. What's that, 80, 90 guys? And that's exactly what I mean by villages can help each other out. It's like our 90 guys coming at them easily. 20, 45, 69, 70. Yeah, 100 guys. Oh, you're about to have a bad day. Yes. Okay, meanwhile, we can watch that from the pop-ups. So see, it says down there one of my dudes killed one of the gatherers. And if they kill one of mine, it will show a blueprint. Perfect. Oh yeah, let's drop loot. Let's do that. Perfect, I found the blueprint. First box. Guys, come pick some of this up. And since there's not really any danger between here and there, I'm not even gonna equip them. But there's only 11 guys, so I'm not gonna send them to, I just got curious what that boss is. I'm not gonna have them burn the first time. I'm gonna let them do a couple loot sessions for me, and then I'll burn the place. Actually, no, I won't. I'm gonna stop burning camps and villages. Or camps and forts. Send your warriors to attack, a lot of times they get, for whatever reason, confused, and you'll see this question mark. So you gotta cancel that, and then they'll go back to the villages. And you can tell which one actually did the deed, because they're gonna be holding the loot. So all that loot is gonna go to village number two. Oh, okay, you're leaving. Sorry. Glad I didn't cancel it. And I need to put the fire on. Stand right on, of course. Okay, so this is a farm. I could What else do I want? I want a couple more stun arrows. Just to be safe, and we are good to go. Make sure I am on concentration. Let's see what we got. Oh, come on. Second to juice out. Now the thing that gets me killed the most is running out of stamina to hold my bow. That would have alerted anybody. So the dude standing out here. It's a lot more convenient if he would just stand by a bush. Check out the sheep on the roof. What the hell is he doing? He really wants to get away, huh?
What's that?
Did that get their attention? A little bit. That'll definitely get your attention.
Something's not right here.
That'll wait.
They're here! They're here!
Shut up. Nobody's anywhere. Okay. Now running into the middle of this
enemy sighted.
Not the smartest idea. So I'm gonna try not to do that. I'm gonna knock a few more of these guys down.
Everyone get ready!
Get ready to go to sleep. Okay, we're okay. I have a choice here. I can pick up the guys I already knocked down. Or I can just finish everybody off.
Enemy sighted!
And you got me, bitch. At least one. Now this guy just worked one of the dudes up. So that's just me.
Guys, they're here!
Oh, say bye to that guy. Alright, was that everybody? I think so. So, I want to go back to the first guys. And they don't seem to be bleeding too fast. Keep an eye on that, make sure I don't bleed out or start bleeding heavily. And I know I'm not going to find a blueprint here, so I'm not even going to bother with it. You never find two blueprints in a row. Oh! That might have been the fifth guy to kill him. Which is pretty much the only way I kill people. I'm trying to go down the list of intimidating the guys that I knocked out first. Most likely to wake up. I got a lot of dudes here. I didn't realize I knocked this many out. Two dudes over there. Meanwhile, I'm still injured. We're looking good. What's up, Cal? I love milk. I'd love to be able to go over there and milk some cows. Oh.
one more dude. Kind of curious how many groceries this place might have. It's been active for quite a while. This should be the last guy. Oh, I met somebody. Okay. Where you at? Oh, right there. No, that's the dude that died. Where's this dude at? So I'm using the detect enemy skill. Wake him up, you damn sheep. Oh, is that payback? Alright, now I can... What am I looking at? Life breathing. Six more warriors. So every time you take out a farm or a camp, you'll have warriors join your village. And if I kill everybody in a farm or a camp, not every time, but if I kill everybody, then those warriors are going to get caught trying to get to your village, and they're going to be sent to a jail. And you're going to have to go release them from the jail, which is both a good and a bad jail. So yeah, I wouldn't expect to get too many groceries out of here, probably about 100. But the upside to killing and having your boys end up in a jail that you have to go and release them from, that you're going to get all the loot from that job. That's a nice shot right there. Wow. I love the graphics in this game, the scenery. So, yeah. You know, the devs always say there's pros and cons to killing. And I think there's very few pros, but one of the pros to killing is this guy going to be a problem? We should go check out that boss. So one of the pros is that when they go to jail and you release them from the jail, you get all the loot from the jail. It's not the biggest pro in the world, but I suppose technically it is a pro. Plus you get more skill points from taking out the people at the jail. Those people too, and you're only going to get half the skill points that you would get if you just intimidated. So, you're just doing twice the work for the same amount of skill points. These are my guys coming to gather to loot. Get it, boys. Sorry. Where am I going?
I saw him!
Hey.
I saw the enemy! Spotted!
Ah. Trigger happy. Oh,
I need to reload!
Hey, do you see anything?
Shot.
I need to reload! Guys, they're here!
Enemy spotted!
Oh,
I think it belongs.
I need to reload!
Bad,
boulder.
You guys are shooting a lot. Suck.
There's an enemy!
I need to reload. Loading.
You good?
Here they are.
We good. Alright, let's see what the hell they did to me. So, I'm gonna go straight doctor back here. Alright, that worked out okay. I'm alright with that. I'm still rusty. Oh, I see a bear. Two bears. Shit. I'm still rusty as hell, but fuck it. Uh-oh. Now I've got to find do you think hopefully those bears just chill over there? Don't catch wind of all this blood. I probably smell it pretty good. These idiots have groceries on or something. Me. Huh. That's gonna be a long walk. Hopefully I didn't miss anybody, and this is the last dude. Bam, right in the back of the neck. Yeah, you got two guns on you, dude. Okay, cool. Portland. We are going to... Well, they haven't made it back yet. Alright, how do I got on me? 116. Oh, where am I? Oh, there we go. I'm at 100 pounds overweight. I can drop all those. It's not going to be 100 pounds, though. What the hell weighs so much? Just all the rifles, huh? That is 200 meters away. Alright, well, I'm gonna do the... I'm gonna do cheesy shit. Where is it? It's all shit. Keep an eye on those bears. Pretty sure, can you guys, I don't know if you guys can see this or not. They're pretty far back there. And there's another one on the hill. Huh. That would have been fun to practice my aim with. Uh-oh. He's starting to make his way over here. Nah, we're good. We're good. I'm starting to get addicted to that fast travel. Way to fast travel. And I'm curious how many grocery the farmhouse. get rid of this good stuff. So we're finding some good battles today, some good fights. Kind of curious as to what boss is over there. Potion that gives you more camouflage. Is it this? Yes. So it gives you 50% desert camo, 10 plains, 10 forest. I want to try to have some of this on me. That's about it, I guess, huh? Oh, those are nice. They weigh a lot, though. Okay. How am I doing on stone arrows? 80. Let's go with at least 40 more. Do I need anything else? Yes, I need some more juice. I don't care about that. Not that. Pretty much one of everything. Takes 3 hay baits to heal your horse. Let's see if we can upgrade them yet. Nope. Damn it. I really want that upgrade. Alright, where are we at? Let's pause for a second. So I knew they're just gonna keep spawning these stupid patrols. And are they done? I don't see the grocery, but I'm sure they have grocery. Okay, so I think I want to go check out this boss. What's going on here? Uh-oh. Ruh-roh. Group from Keller Farms. There's no way you're going to make it. Oh, you did, huh? I'm really surprised. Oh, and those are level 3 warriors. Yeah, you better not mess with them. I'm surprised they were able to make it by. What else killers find? Huh. Alright, let's go check out. Looking frag. Like, I want to go hit up a boss while I got a patrol roaming on me. Is that his turnaround point? That would be good if it is. Let's go check out this boss. See if this is Ninja Boy. I wouldn't mind taking out Ninja Boy. I'd rather do him than the bandits. The bandits can be kind of a pain in the ass. Okay, so let's put this in the middle. And of course the patrols are going to keep coming. Alright. Yep. Awesome. That's awesome. Did I leave it on here? I don't think I did. Damn. Okay, I gotta go get my gun. Let's get Ninja Boy. Only thing I use the gun for in this game. as I know, it's really the only way to get this guy. Alright, so... I want his gun, which is a 54 cal. I think I could do it with his gun. Okay, let's go 54. Take 20. Then we need 75. Take 20. What's my weight at? 110. Okay. Meanwhile. Yeah, I don't see the grocery. So I want to go and be like over here. Alright. Hopefully I don't screw this up. We're gonna eat this one that gives us camo. Now the thing is, I need to be able to see him. He doesn't look like he's 100. Oh, wait. I'm freaking myself out. I'm thinking, God, he's only 100. I got off my horse way too soon. Okay. I'm tripping myself out. I'm overthinking. I was like, oh shit, he's only 50. How come he hasn't disappeared? The trick with him is you gotta really take your time. He should be right out there if I could get to him. Try to spot him. Oh, the scope. Nope. I
have that right on the center, right? Okay. So he should be over this ridge. Yeah, I don't see him yet. Should I hope he's not over that ridge? I'm never gonna sneak up on him if he is. Shit. I gotta find high ground if I wanna stand a chance. Only way I know kill this guy is to see him before he sees you. You want to be at like the maximum spawning distance. And he likes to sit with his legs crossed. So he doesn't make a very big target. He really should be spawned in somewhere. There he is. I wonder if I should use this gun. Yeah, that's not gonna work. Okay. Got him. And there you go. That is how you get Ninja Boy. He's still got his legs crossed. That is fun. That's a very zen pose. You're mine. Oh, the things I find fun. Right through my face. See if I can pick him up a little bit. Yeah, that's a little bit. Oh, that's a pretty cool screenshot, really. There we go. Huh. Oh, that's kind of cool. Oh, that's fucked up. Oh, there's my screenshot right there. I like it.
I wish I could mount this guy on my wall. Put him in my teepee. Just look him in the eye. What's happening? How you feeling, bro? Huh? You okay? You might be okay. Anyway. Alright, that's enough of that. Alright. That made me happy. Gotta tell the chat about that. Name Jones, right? God damn it, learn how to spell. But I did that at the 2 hour mark. That would have been a good way to start a stream. Actually, I'm at a 2 hour mark. I should call this a stream while I'm ahead. Now. You need to come here. I think this time. Oh, wait, no, I'm not burning anymore. Okay, one more time. And I want to. Those are reestablished farms. I don't want to mess around with that. That might be reestablished too. I might have already taken that, I'm not sure. I'm gonna ignore these patrols. So I wanna come up here. That was cool. That made me happy. Got him the first try. Well, like I said, the trick with him is trying to find him at the furthest point of his spawning. If I had gone another, say, like 10, 15 meters forward, he would have heard me and be gone. So you get one chance, one shot. One shot, one kill. That was awesome. So we're gonna drop all this back on. I'm gonna post a screenshot on the Discord just because I can. ...130 health bar, that's actually really, really good. How much does that weigh? 5 weighs 3.5. Interesting. What about trading? Let's see what's going on here. 9 minutes to get my next bow. Now see what I was talking about with the dimes? The offer is back up. So now he's selling them at 7. So I just come in and I just made 3,752 trading tokens. There you go. Just that easy. Ah, you're selling for 14. That's all. All good. All good. That's a good price for those arrows. Nothing too exciting. Am I making any money? 26, 5, 6, 8, 10. Not bad. I just redid my market not too long ago. I got about 10 grand in the last couple of hours. Let's see, what did the chat say? Okay, it shuts off. Hey, type. What is that skill? It is chief and leadership. Per what? Per upgrade, I guess? There you go, I guess that makes sense.
really got to do a little video on my skills that I upgrade. As you can see here, I only upgrade a few of them. So this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I upgrade 13, so 13 skills. The rest of these I could care less about. I've got 4,100 skill points, but I really don't care. Now, if I didn't have a feeder and I had to go gather, then I would be upgrading my chief skills for sure. Which at some point I suppose I will. But why do it till I need it? Alright, well that was a lot of fun. So I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will catch you on the next one. Peace out.